Welcome back to the Model Workshop. Look at this monster. The whole box doesn't even fit in the screen. This is AMT's Construction Bulldozer in 1/25th scale, made up of over 350 1/25th scale parts. We got the big engine, the big six-cylinder. We've got the optional digging blade for the back. We've got the ripper. We've got the movable blade in the front. We've got the full track system with over 80 individual track sections that just snap together. And if you're an armor modeler like I am, I was hoping for vinyl tracks or snap together. We got the highly detailed snap together type on this one, which is awesome. I've never seen this kit before. It is a re-release. It was used to be called the Caterpillar D8H. It's still the exact same kit. They just couldn't use that name for obvious reasons. So let's take a look at everything that's going to be inside the box when you get yours. Now, because this is a full build review, I'm not going to go over every single part. We're going to take an overview so we can get to working. The instruction manual is a huge fold-out sheet. Over 350 parts, 80 of which are in the tracks. Means you're going to be doing a lot of work. Look at all the detail on that massive Caterpillar diesel there. So let's pull that to the side. In this box bag here, I don't want to go through them all, but we've got the nice snap-together track system and vinyl hose for the hydraulics. So that's awesome. We're going to be working on those individually. We've got a large chrome tree as far as size goes. Now, there really isn't much chrome on a Caterpillar D8H, so we're going to be stripping almost all of this except for the hydraulic rams there. We're going to cut those free, set them aside. I'm going to soak these in super clean and get all that chrome off there so I can paint everything the factory colors. Now, let's get the giant stack of yellow plastic out here. All right, we've got one part there that came off the trees. You can see that. Now, we'll take a look at some of the stuff in here before I throw it in the parts cleaner and start building. We got the nice Caterpillar blade. I know you'd want to see that right away. We've got some chassis parts, back of the blade, which is what that is. We've got some of the ripper parts. Check them out. All right, nice detail. We've got the rams. We've got parts of the bulldozing blade system here. We've got the drive wheels, the idlers, the rollers. We'll just go through these nice and quick. What I'm going to do is I've got a can of farm color spray paint. I'm going to get to painting this in the actual Caterpillar colors. You can see that nice tank there. What do we got over here? We've got engine parts for that big six-cylinder diesel for the D8H. Manifolds, intakes, turbo parts, transmission, drive system. So this is awesome. I've never built a bulldozer before. We got that beautiful hood with the cutouts. We've got all of our sides. We've got our seat, dash components, torsion suspension. Check that out. Check that big assembly out there. It's as big as my hand. More parts of the ripper or the optional tow bar. Hydraulics for the ripper. The bar for the ripper. That's all sweet. And then we've got our drive line right there. And our transmission halves. So that's everything that's going to be inside the box. Now I'm going to get all these parts in the parts washer. I'm going to get the chrome dechroming and we'll be back when I've got some sub-assemblies set. We'll see you soon. All right, I've got everything dechroming and washing. I want to show you the decals while I start building. We've got the Universal Construction logos. We've got the Oakland Builder Supply Company. We've got Bloomfield Construction. We've got three grill options. Now, I like that Universal Construction. You could use that with the AMT gear hauler, the blazer they have out. You can put those logos on everything. So this is probably the grill I'm going to use. I'm going to get back to work. We're going to start putting things together and let you know how it looks. See you soon. Welcome back for a little bit of a progress report. We're doing some of the sub-assemblies. What I've done is I've assembled the entire inline six diesel, and that is a huge engine, as you're going to see. And then I've also gone on to step two and assembled the frame and the beginning of the gear cases. So I wanted to show you how we've gotten here so far. This part on the front that's just on there loosely and wants to fall off is the radiator cover. That's where our little grill is going to go on there for the decal. So we'll just set that on the side. Now, I've never built this kit before. So one of my questions was, am I going to be able to build the engine and still get it in and out of the frame while I'm detailing and painting it, because I want to make this a little bit of a rusty, dusty ride, so I don't want to have to spray it all as one and try to work on it inside here, even though the engine's all yellow, just like the machine. Well, I can tell you that, yes, you can, actually. You can assemble the entire frame and still get the engine in and out while you're working. The easy way to do that is you build it just as they want. You glue in the radiator. You can see the radiator is glued in between the body panels here with the nice rivet detail on them. The crossbar here with the pivot point for the blade is there. You'll leave that pin loose if you can see it sliding out a little bit. You leave that loose so that it rotates a little bit. But the radiator shroud you do not glue in, and we're going to slide that out over the top of the engine. That's that part right there. Don't glue that in until we're almost all done with the model. We can paint that on the outside yellow, and then it will just slide back in and key into place and hold. Once that's out, you can get the engine in and out. You have to do the back end first, though, because your fan is in front of this bar here. But I wanted this bar here to make sure I had the right amount of separation between the two fender pieces there, between the two side pieces. So you do want to glue that in. But if you just work it very carefully, gently, you'll see that eventually you'll get it to just pop right out. And then you can slide that massive six-cylinder out of there. Let's take a look at that. Now, this whole thing is going to get sprayed with yellow. The chrome that AMT uses is really, really strong. I don't know who does their chrome, if they do it in-house, but it's very strong. This was overnight soaking in super clean at straight value. It wasn't diluted. And I got most of it off so I can glue and attach, and it's scuffed up enough now with a brush that I will be able to spray paint that very easily in Caterpillar yellow without having any issues. Came off the fan front pretty easy, but on the back, of course, a lot of it stayed on. So you can see, we'll show you some other stuff where the chrome came off the back real nice. On the drive wheels and on the footrests, there's still a lot on there, but the nice thing is it's pitted and beat up now, so the paint will stick when I have to go to paint it. Now, that six-cylinder is a gorgeous engine. I mean, it even has overflow lines, dipstick, oil pump, transmission. Got our starter solenoids. We've got our turbo here. Now, I did lose, there's, you know, where you got your pipe here to go up to your turbo with your exhaust. I did lose the piece that goes in here. I don't know where it went. I had it. It was cut off. It was on here. And when I went to glue it on, I couldn't find it. What's nice is you can just cut a piece of thin sprue, heat it up, bend it in place, and move it in. And then I'll just have to do just a little bit of putty on the top and bottom to make that fit in there real nice. But the air cleaner's on there. The air, the exhaust are all right there. We've got our alternator. We've got our water lines. I mean, it's just a beautiful thing. This whole thing will get painted yellow. We'll make it a little crusty, a little dusty, a little oily. We'll paint the drive belt black, of course. But that, otherwise, if you look at these rebuild engines, if you looked at these engines anywhere, Caterpillar just pretty much hosed them down with yellow, the entire vehicle. So when we do, the main things will be in the washing and the detailing and working on that to get that off there. So that's a beautiful engine. Move on to the frame here. That is a big slug of plastic. Don't be afraid to go crazy with the glue on this. Use a good quality glue. I'm not plugging for them, but I've always used Plastruck Bondine because it melts the parts together and it holds tight. But you can see our gear cases there, our under fenders. The model's almost shiny with glue. And that, we know then, I can drop it, I can flip it, I can flop it, and we're not going to have stuff flying all over the place. So that's coming out real nice. We got the radiator in, and I will be able to drop that engine in after I detail it, wash it up, and after I paint the whole chassis, the frame there. So I'm going to continue working. Next up in the manual, as we can see, I'm going to be doing the operator platform with the seat, the footrests, the hydraulic tanks, the fuel tanks, the control tower, the hood, everything that's on there. I'll be putting all that together. Then I'll be working on the plow and the drivetrain system of the thing. We'll be back when I get done with those steps. See you soon. As you can see in this part, things are going just fine. I've got the drivetrain suspension on. You can see that great detail underneath with all the road wheels, the drive wheels, the idlers. Everything's on there. That's got that nice sway suspension on either side with glues in. And of course, it all looks nice and shiny from all the glue I use, so that I can have the model sit, not have to worry about moving anything around or having it snap off or fall off. The tracks go together super nice. I have wanted armor making companies to make tracks this easy, and just recently they started finally doing so, but this is absolutely great. They all snap together. You use one sprue per side. They just push click together. You can see on there, they just snap snap. You can put those right around the drive wheels. I'll be weathering these up separately and laying them on. You can have access to them during the entire time. The kit looks great. It's going together without any problems, without any frustrations or issues or anything to drive you nuts. Next up is going to be to assemble the blade and the ripper on the back. Then I skipped step number 3, which is the operator platform, so that I can paint up and weather the engine. Once I have the plow together and the ripper blade together, then I will start painting everything up, and I will get that engine in place once it's painted and weathered. Then I will get the operator's platform on. Then I can mask off where the engine is on the side and start painting the rest of the model. So I'm going to keep continuing. When I get the dozer blade done and the ripper blade done, we'll take a look at those. We got a lot done in just a couple of seconds. We got all sets of the tracks assembled. Those are awesome. Those need to be painted, rusted up, chipped up, and weathered. So those can go off to the side. Those can get work. What I have here now is the complete blade assembly, the dozer blade. You can see that's very attractive. Now I have it compressed. I have these cylinders compressed all the way, just so that I can hide those nice chrome work on the plastic for when I paint. I don't have to worry about covering up that chrome. The ends here would always be painted anyways on the vehicle, so we don't have to worry about that. We've got all our torsion bars, all our support bars, all our supports on the plow glued into place. This is ready, once it's painted, to go back here and be snapped into place, and our hydraulic arms join in back up here. Okay, so that's all ready to go. And then the plow, because we didn't glue these solid, and because these pins here, of course, won't be glued, we'll be able to move that plow up and down, touching or not touching the ground. We've got the ripper blade, which will do the same thing. I just glued it together, so I'm not going to move it right now. But if you assemble it the right way, you can still move that around and adjust it. This needs to be painted cat yellow, and then beat up, chipped up, and banged up, and installed on the back right here of the Caterpillar. So I don't have the control area installed yet. What I'm going to do now, as you can see, I've got the first coat of yellow, Caterpillar yellow, on the nice engine there. Looks great. We're going to let that dry. I'm going to go ahead and shoot down all three of these parts with the same Caterpillar yellow, get that first coat on them. Then I'm going to grime up the engine back here, get it all oily and nasty looking, and drop that in. Then I can assemble the control area. Once I assemble the control area, I just have to mask it off and paint it. And then we'll just mask it off from everything else. We'll shoot some cat yellow paint on it. And then we get to the fun part of weathering, greasing, and dirtying up everything. So when the engine is weathered and installed, we'll come back, take a look at that. Told you I'd be working on the engine. What I did, you can see the difference in the color of the paint on the engine now and on the actual Caterpillar frame here. So I spray paint originally with Rust-Oleum Old Caterpillar Yellow. This is an enamel paint, so it takes at least 5 to 6 hours to harden up. Then what I do, once that's all hardened up and I know I can coat it again, I hit it with some of this new sugar paint from Australia in a banana split yellow color, a very, very faint matte yellow, and it's an acrylic. It's an acrylic spray paint with a water-based carrier, which means it won't disturb the enamel underneath. I shoot the engine just in a very mist coat to bring that color down and look like a faded, used yellow. That's what we want. Then I go on there and I start running my oil and grease streaks. That's just a black-brown mix of acrylics that I run down over the engine. All right, we'll bring that up here a little closer so you can see it. We'll move the Caterpillar body there, and you can see it's still wet on there. What the actual other colors are on here are real rust. And how I make real rust is you don't have to go buy paints. You don't have to go do anything like that. All you have to do is make real rust. How do you make real rust, Chris? Well, pay attention, all right? You take steel wool, cheap steel wool, dollar store, Walmart, I don't care, steel wool, not spick and span. Don't get the stuff with soap in it, plain steel wool. Then you take hydrogen peroxide, all right? The stuff you use in the bathroom to fix a canker sore or clean out anything, and table salt, all right? Steel wool, hydrogen peroxide, table salt. Mix those up together. The amounts don't matter. Enough hydrogen peroxide to cover the steel wool, and you can see it's just a small piece. Use a glass container because it's going to get a little warm, and do this outside. Do it out on the driveway, wherever. You don't have to worry about fumes, okay? This is going to create likely hydrogen gas. It bubbles up something. I don't know if it's creating pure oxygen or hydrogen, depending on the reaction between the chemicals, and it doesn't really matter. Do it outside. Mix up your table salt, your hydrogen peroxide, and your steel wool. Just pour in your hydrogen peroxide over the steel wool. Nothing will happen. Then sprinkle in table salt, and you'll see within a half an hour it will instantly rust, all right? I used to use vinegar, but vinegar will react with enamels and acrylics, and it's more acidic. It'll start to pull them off and all that stuff, so I don't mess with that anymore. Hydrogen peroxide's pretty inert. Once the salt and the steel wool have reacted and rusted, half an hour later, after a little bit of bubbling, maybe some fumes outdoors, you'll get a nice rust solution, all right? And you can keep using that steel wool till it pretty much disintegrates. So wear a glove like you see me wearing, because look at the stain. I mean, it even stains vinyl gloves. And then I just take it out and I squeeze it over the top of the motor and the sides and let it run down. This is how it happens in real life. Gunk oil from changing fuel filters, oil filters, everything runs down and gunks up the whole motor, all right? You can see we get some larger drips by letting it drip down, some smaller ones. You can see where they've had oil leaks before. You can see where the oil out of the turbo has been changed and leaked and made a mess and everything, all right? So we're going to let this sit and dry. Takes about an hour from now to dry. Then I'm going to place it inside the frame, the chassis here, okay? Once that's glued in, then I can assemble the operator's platform above it and work on all that. Then I'll mask off the engine and I'll spray that. So what I'll do once I have all that done is I'll go ahead and give it a couple mist coats of that light yellow. That will bring it down to that faded Caterpillar yellow with some hints of darker yellow underneath is what we want. I've also been working on the tracks. Last time you saw them, they were all silver, which is great. I like the metallic look. What I did was I took some red primer, just some rusty red primer, you can see it, sprayed the tracks, got them that crusty, rusty look. Then I took some of the yellow, again, the acrylic, which doesn't hurt anything when you spray it on there, and I sprayed that down so that we had some of the yellow overcoat still there, because these come painted all yellow. They paint the tracks and everything, and then as they get beat up and worn. So I'll keep working on that. The tracks still need to be dry brushed to bring out the silver highlights on the top of the treads. We're going to add some dirt, some mud, maybe a little more rusty tones to them. I'm definitely going to be dripping on some more of my rust solution once we get them on there. I've also got, of course, weather all this stuff. So there's quite a bit of work left to do. I'm going to keep plugging away. When I get the operator station in after the engine and get the operator station weathered down and detail painted, we'll come back, take another look, see where I am. Primary assembly of all the components is completed now. You can see how awesome this thing looks and the actual size of it. You know, each one of those squares is 1 square inch. We got the tracks assembled. We're just starting to work on weathering them. Those will go on just about when we're all done with everything. We've got the ripper all assembled and painted in that delicious yellow. We've got the main chassis. Now you can see the work that I did since the last break. I installed that engine. Then I'm able to install the dashboard, the operator's platform, hydraulic tank, fuel tank, seats, shift levers, foot pedals, and all that is all installed. You can better look back here. We'll tilt it up. Bring it in nice and close. You can see all that nice detail back there. So, what do we have to do now? Now that we've got everything assembled, you can see how it goes together, and it just looks phenomenal. I have to give all this paint up here a coat of the cat yellow, including the operator's footboard, the seat, everything will get painted yellow. Then I'll pick out the details with a paintbrush, put some wear on these panels here, paint that, give it that nice light yellow overcoat to fade everything. Everything will get a coat of that acrylic. Then we'll go in and do some weathering. So when I get this coat of paint on here and start detailing the cab and the seat and the pedals, we'll take another look before I put everything together and then start doing the fading and the weathering all as one unit. While we're waiting for the masked off sections that I just completed for the operator's platform to dry, and then we can do the assembly and start weathering everything, I'm going to finish off the tracks. Now what I've done here is I've got them all done. You can see they look pretty awesome. All I have to do now is clear coat them and drip in some of my rust solution to really get it down in there. But how did I get them this far? What the detail is, you can see on there, is they look a little rusty, a little crusty, but they don't look completely destroyed and not used up. These things travel in mud, mire, you know, on the beach and construction zones and all that, so the tracks rust almost instantly. So how we did that, I showed you before. I sprayed it with the red primer, then I shot it with that faded yellow paint, that flat paint. What I did then was I got out some burnt sienna in an acrylic tube. Okay? Got this for like $1.49 on clearance. Squirted that into my palette. I used one brush for this entire technique. Shot that into my palette. Then I went through and brushed more rust in the edges of the tracks. Once I got done with that, I cleaned off my brush. Then I did a bunch of dry brushing with gunmetal and silver. Just Folk Art gunmetal and Ceramcoat silver. I first did the gunmetal and I brushed it around and around and around and around. Then I took my silver, brushed it over. The only part that I used silver on was the very tips, the very freshest metal on the very tips of the teeth of the tracks. Then I flipped them back over and I got out my pastels and just sticks of pastels, and I rubbed in the center of each one. Worked them all the way through, ground it in there, and you can see the tones that start to appear on those tracks actually start to look like rust and crust and dirt and metal, and we've got varied textures, and we've got other, you know, different colors in there. We've got all kinds of cool stuff going on in there. So they look like real Caterpillar tracks, depending on how you use it. The nicest part is, as you concentrate all your wear on the top and the bottom, where do you get the least amount of wear? On the side of your tracks, where a lot of that yellow paint is still available. So they still look like the original yellow painted tracks on the sides. So when you look at it from that angle, you're going to have it looking like a real set of tracks on a real Caterpillar. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to clear coat these with a matte clear coat to protect all the work I've done with the pastels, the acrylics, the dry brushing. This has all been acrylics aside from the spray painted red primer. Then once that's dry, I'll go in with my rust solution and I will drip it all over it so that it actually gets into all the nooks and crannies. Let that dry, and then my tracks are completely done. They're completely ready to go. They're rusty, but they're not completely used up. They've got a lot of good metal. You can see the steel showing. Anytime he takes on and off the trailer, drives through, those edges always get cleaned off and sanded clean. So with one brush, three colors of paints, and a 299 set of pastels, you can make some real nice Caterpillar tracks. I'm going to let that other paint dry. When we come back, I'm going to be already working on the weathering of the main body. Right up in your face! The cab, the actual Caterpillar itself, is out of the paint booth. You can see once I attach those tracks, they're not joined together. They're just laid over. Those are going to look so awesome on there. They're just going to look beat up. They're going to look used. I've still got to weather everything. I got it out of the Caterpillar paint booth. I pulled my masks out from where I had the engine. And then I give it that light shot of the lighter faded yellow as well to give it that faded paint. Now, I also weathered up the plow, the dozer blade back here. You'll get closer looks at this, of course, later, using multiple different Vallejo colors of rust, some Model Master enamel stains, rust and oils. I did the same with the Ripper Blade. Used my metallics, of course, my two favorite metallics, to dry brush, along with some metallic silver from Ceramcoat. Got in there, beat it up, made Wheelus look like we've got oil and stuff dripping off the right parts there. So those are ready to be mounted, and then do a final combined weathering to bring it all together. What do I have to do on the Caterpillar itself right now? I have to paint the seat black. I have to paint all the little handles black. I'm going to do some wear and chipping and weathering. Sponge chipping is what I'll be doing next, which is super easy. You just take these cosmetic sponges from the dollar store. There's like 30 of them for a buck. You tear off little pieces. You hold them with your tweezers. You dip them in your acrylic paint. You make sure most of it is off and all these different rough edges. Then you'll just go along and add some chips here and there. Some beat up weathering. We'll do some dry brushing along the handles here. We're going to paint the stack a charcoal black like a pavement and then give it some rust highlights because these rust out immediately. Then when we do all that, then I've got to go through and give it my rust stain, my real rust stain. Let everything drip and run down in greasy areas and whatnot. Then we'll be on to final assembly. Just before I'm ready to slap it all together, I'll be back for one last look. Here's the final look before we assemble everything. I've got that nice vinyl hose on the Ripper Blade, and what's left over is about that much there. So actually, it's really nice hose. It's also hollow, so it goes on to ends easily. If you wanted to hose up some other stuff here, do some connections, do some wiring, you could really go crazy with this model, of course, super detailing, but they do fit nicely on those hydraulics there. We got the blade done. We've got everything rusty, dusty, dirty, beat up just the way I wanted it, used but not used up, my favorite saying. We are getting ready to do final assembly. So what I have to do is I'm going to attach the tracks, which I just love. Then I'm going to attach the blade because that kind of snaps over. And then I'm going to glue the ripper on the back. So then once those are all attached, I got to dust this thing up because no Caterpillar is just going to be dirty. It's going to be dirty and dusty. So once it's all together, we're going to go ahead and shoot it down with a dull coat. Then after that, we will give it a dust and we'll have a final reveal. I'll see you soon. This is it. We're finally done. This kit took me 2 days. Normally I can pound out a kit in about a day. This one was 2 full days of work, but boy, was it worth it. Over 350 parts, optional ripper or toe hitch on the back. I had to have the ripper on there. Nice vinyl hoses included. Built it up. Weathered it up, beat it up, made it look like a real working Caterpillar bulldozer. I used the Universal Construction grill, used the Universal Construction emblems all over it. Still leaves me with the other two companies on the sheet and two other grills. Decals went on just fine, released after 30 seconds in water. No problems at all. I absolutely love it. The track assembles so nice. With just the right amount of sag in it. Looks like they need to loosen it up, tighten it back up in the front end. I love that huge diesel under the hood. That comes out so nice. Builds up. No fit issues, no problems. Take a little bit closer look at that blade. There will be a slideshow at the end with much more detailed still pictures for you to look at. But it's a beautiful kit. I never had a chance to own this before. I'm so glad I have it now. There'll be a link in the description where you can pick yours up. I really enjoyed you coming along with this. Of course, the dust effects, as always, are just done with tile grout, wet down here, and then covered with Future so that they stay wet looking. And then up here, it's just dusted on with a paintbrush so that it looks like nice dust effects and brings everything together. Absolutely fantastic kit. I really enjoyed it. Check out the detail on that thing. Like I said, there'll be a slideshow at the end. Link in the description where you can get a copy of yours. We'll see you at the next review.